r/AskReddit. Men of Reddit, what's the hardest thing to explain to women? When we say we need time or space, that's exactly what we need. It's not code for you need to try harder. When you ask me how my day was or what I did today, nothing in my day usually stands out as special. So I just don't remember. I usually don't remember what I do. I just live. Too clean for the hamper. Too dirty for the drawer. That's why I put my cargo shorts on the floor. I have a spot in the closet hidden from my wonderful but short wife where pants go for further use. I'm seriously not checking you out every time you walk by in the office. I turn my head for damn near everything that enters my periphery. You're really not that special. This makes me so ducking self-conscious in the gym. Every time someone walks past I look, especially in the mirrors, and I always catch the eye of a girl probably thinking I'm checking her out. I really don't want to be seen as that creepy guy making girls at the gym uncomfortable. It's literally the last thing I'm thinking about. Sometimes an erection just happens. We don't control the thing. It's a physical response that could literally be from nothing. I accidentally walked into a door the other day and I got rock hard. Kinky. Sometimes, this is me personally so I can't say it's common, the struggle not to share emotions isn't as much the worry of backlash from society or friends, etc. It's more just a conflict within ourselves to verbalize and come out with it. I trust my friends with respecting how I feel. I just can't get it out because I'm fighting myself. Edit. I'm glad this has helped some people focus a general feeling into a somewhat coherent thought. I hope someday we all can climb out of this better people. I don't always want to be the one that initiates sex. It makes me feel like a creep. It doesn't necessarily make me feel like a creep, but it makes me think the girl doesn't actually want sex most of the time. When a girl does ask for sex or initiates it in her own way, it makes it so much more fun for me and takes out a lot of the anxiety and stress that sometimes surround sex in a relationship because it really does feel like a two-sided give and receive situation. I've tried so hard to explain this to my GF and previous girlfriends before. It's really hard to vocalize. They think I'm not interested since I don't want to initiate all the time, and that's really not the case. The specifics of nod code. It's easy to say up if you know them, down if you don't, but the exact meaning of the downward nod is hard to translate. It's seeing them, acknowledging them, and saying that neither of us have any issue with each other. When we say we don't care, we really don't care. Yes, we can have an opinion on something, but when we say we don't care, that means our opinion isn't strong enough to sway us either way on something. I learned to say I don't have a preference. That always seems to come across better. Pee at an angle. Or the vaunted split stream, usually post-erection. That sometimes we need personal space and it has nothing to do with our opinion of you. Definitely, when I first moved in with this girl, she wasn't working and I was. So, every day I would be up at 6 a.m. to go to work, and then back late on an evening to find her, her brother, her friends, all sitting around the living room and all wanting to talk to me, like, sod off, I just got in from work, can I have 5 minutes alone to just reset myself? Alone time is great and everyone should have at least 30 minutes of it daily. How much compliments mean to us? It's a different type of happy when a guy gets complimented. I got like 3 real compliments from people that I take at least a little seriously. Oh, and speaking of compliments, I like your name. Edit. 4 compliments. Edit 2. 5 holy moly. Sometimes we could use a hug. Or at least a high five. We appreciate women making the first move. Making the first move feels like stepping on eggshells. We're still a human, so that means we have feelings too. So please take care when choosing your words when you're arguing with us. My ex would say horrible things when fighting, then wonder why I was not in the mood to duck her for a few days afterwards. Seriously, I have learned to hate teachers that would teach the sticks and stones rhyme because the truth is stick and stones can break bones and harsh words will ducking destroy your self-esteem for years, requiring mental counseling, and even then you might never heal. I really want to see if we'll get along well enough to date, but I'm horrible at maintaining a conversation without being too safe or too out there. Edit. Award speech edit type beat. I'm just horrible at maintaining conversations at all. that the reason I shake the gas pump the amount of time I do after I finish pumping gas is the same reason I shake my dong after I pee. It's just good sense. Why, I don't know what the duck my best friend is up to in life even after hanging out with him all day. I chat with my friend for an hour on the phone. We talk about video games, sports, etc. He's been my friend from high school and we were best men in each other's weddings. So, after the call, my wife says, "What's going on with his family?" "I don't know. You didn't talk about his family?" "Look, I'm sure they are fine. If they weren't, he would have told me." That I am simply not clairvoyant. You need to tell me what it is you really want. If you're disappointed in something, say so. I can take it, as long as it's not number 1. 3. This dilemma. If I ask you what's wrong, and you say nothing, am I supposed to believe you or call you a liar? That men can sit for hours talking and talk about nothing. And it is really okay to interrupt us from talking for hours about things that we seem to understand but really have no freaking clue whatsoever. We will likely to pick it up again next weekend and continue our discussion. That just because I'm quiet in your presence doesn't mean I'm upset. Just means I'm either tired, don't have anything to say, or I'm thinking about something. Yay, dude, I feel this one. My default state is sitting quietly. My roommate, however, feels the need to fill every silence she encounters with words. I think that she interprets my quietness as me not wanting to talk to her, when in reality I just have nothing to say at the moment. As much as we're seen as sex-crazed pigs, we talk so little about women when we get together for drinks or something like that, and when we do, the topic doesn't last long. Literally can't even remember when was the last time me and my best bud talked about women. We're both single too. Just usually talking about our old friends from school and what they're doing. Cars, our jobs, sport, or politics occasionally. An itch on my dong is way way worse than an itch anywhere else. An itching dong on a children's playground is one of life's worst pranks. Sometimes I'm just horny, but in a committed relationship sometimes I'll look at you and I'm just so in love that I want to be as close and intimate with you as I can. Which is sex. My ex and I had different love languages, and she would worry that I don't love her as much as she loves me, which was just crazy because I was head over heels for her at all times. Trying to explain that really close, lovey sex was one of the ways I showed her exactly how deeply I was in love with her, but she didn't get it. That just because I'm a guy doesn't mean I don't care. I've had women talk to me about guys losing their hair. He's a guy, so he doesn't care. I know a lot of guys who hate being bald or the fact that they are balding and their hair is thinning and hairline is receding. This idea that we don't care or don't care about our looks because we are a guy is ridiculous. The fact that we can't ride in a car with another man for 5 hours and not say a word drives my wife crazy. I drove 400 miles with my father to go see my sister, and most of our conversation topics were about when we will stop and eat something and how good our meals were. I have to constantly explain to my wife why my 2-year-old son is obsessed with his penis. I have to explain why he always wants to touch it and grab it when his diaper is off. She will never understand why our baby and his father share this habit. Edit. It seems I should have worded this a little differently. The feeling of getting kicked in the nuts or straight up right in the shaft that immobilizes you and leaves you in fetal position with the feeling of needing to throw up while at the same time having sharp radiating pain from your a-hole through your neck. Edit. Guess I can kind of explain it. Also, it's a delayed reaction. You only start to feel real pain in about 5 seconds. Why we bottle our emotions up. This. My wife and I lost a dog in our second year of marriage. He was sick for a month and she was crying softly about it on a daily basis. I was extremely sad, but never cried. Then when they took him away at the vet's office, I cried loudly and uncontrollably for what felt like an hour. Probably realistically like 45 seconds though, and just couldn't calm myself down. In the car she said, "You know, if you didn't bottle up and let it out a little at a time, you wouldn't get like that." What she didn't understand at that moment is that for a lot of men, we don't have that middle ground of crying. It's either nothing or everything. A lot of us never learned how to cry in a semi-controlled manner because we never saw a man do that when we were young. I'm 40 years old and I've never seen my father cry. Not at any of our weddings. not at his parents' funerals, nothing. In other words, I've never had that subconscious model of how a man is supposed to cry, and don't have any practice at it. When I try to make myself cry, I can't. Whereas my wife can watch any commercial with sick animals, cry quietly for 5 seconds and then be done with it. We'd love to be able to share what is really on our minds, sexual and non-sexual and every topic and viewpoint under the sun, except we're afraid of the relationship consequences. Most of us don't get complimented, so if you do give us one, we'll remember it forever. One time after getting a haircut and wearing a rather nice new outfit, I was shopping at Target. The 5-foot-tall middle-aged Hispanic checker smiled and said, "You look like a mooable." I blushed and stuttered out a thank you. This was like 5 years ago. For reference, I do not know have I ever looked like a model.